Welcome, my dear students. Today, our subject is Maths. In Maths, we are going to learn chapter number 17, Handling Data. So first, let us see what is data. A collection of information of a certain thing is called data. When we use pictures or symbols to represent such data, it is called pictorial representation. Such pictorial representations are called pictographs. Pictographs have three important information: title, data or label, key, that is the picture to be used. Each image stands for a certain number of things. A watch company manufactures watches from Monday to Saturday. The table shown on the screen is the data given by the company. Let us make a pictograph to represent the watches manufactured. Let us make a pictograph step by step. Number 1. Draw a table and label it as days and number of wrist watches manufactured. Number 2. Write the days as per the data. Number 3. Start drawing the pictures as per the data in the table. 4. Monday, 60 watches are made. Each watch represents 10 watches. So 6 pictures have to be made. We draw the pictures as per the data. Tuesday, 70 watches are made. So 7 pictures have to be made here. Wednesday, 60 watches are made. So 6 pictures are drawn here. Thursday, 80 watches are made. So 8 pictures have to be made. Friday, 60 watches are made. So 6 pictures have to be made. Saturday, 50 watches are made, so 5 pictures have to be made. This is the final pictograph. Now let's see what is next. Interpreting the data from a given pictograph. Now that we know to make a pictograph, we should also know to read or interpret a given pictograph. Let us take an example of a fruit seller who sold the following number of different fruits as shown in the pictograph. Each picture represents 20 fruits. On the basis of that, the pictograph shows. Let us complete the table. Solution: each fruit represents 20 fruits. So apples sold are 5 multiplied by 20, that is equal to 100 apples. Bananas sold are 4 multiplied by 20, that is equal to 80 bananas. Guavas sold are 6 multiplied by 20, that is equal to 120 guavas. Pineapples sold are 6 multiplied by 20, that is equal to 120 pineapples. We can draw the following conclusion from this pictograph. Guavas and pineapples are sold in the same number. The fruit which is sold the least is banana. Remember, a pictograph or a picture graph is a graph that uses symbol to represent data. We need to look carefully at the key to determine how many items are represented by each symbol. Now let's see tally chart. Have you ever wondered how earlier civilization learned to count? The first method of counting was counting on fingers. How did they remember the counting? Researchers and archaeologists shows early civilizations used tally marks to remember the counting. They used bones from early Europeans and African cultures. Lines were carved into the bones to denote a number with tally marks, which could be considered the first tally chart to show a form of data collection and representation. Now let us see what is tally marks. The collected data is represented by this symbol. Each mark represents one data. Grouping the tally marks in phi makes it easier for us to total the number in each category by skip counting. A bundle of phi's are made by crossing it. Tally charts could always be given the title to inform the reader about the meaning of the data. A tally marks and the corresponding numbers are shown on the screen. Number 1 shows 1 mark. Number 2 shows 2 marks. Number 3 shows 3 marks. Number 4 shows 4 marks. Number 5 shows 4 marks and a cross mark, and so on. 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. The screen shows the tally chart of the favorite sports of students. Let us observe it carefully. From the given tally chart, we observe that hockey is liked by 6 students, soccer is liked by 5 students, basketball is liked by 4 students, and gymnastics is liked by 2 students. Tally charts are easier than the pictographs, as it takes more time to draw pictures, but it takes lesser time to draw lines as in tally charts. But tally charts are for small data collection, mostly used for data less than 50 or 100. For larger data, marking lines of tally will take more time. Let's see some more examples. It was Sonu's birthday. Her friends had came for her birthday party. Everyone wished her happy birthday and also gave her gifts. Now, Sonu wants to sort out the collection of her gifts. Her friends help her. Tony put the gifts into groups. Salma counted the books. Sonu counted the pens and Tony counted the pencil. Nandu wrote down this information on a slate. So, Sonu got 30 gifts in all, and here this became a table. By seeing the table, we can understand that Sonu received gifts. In that gifts, she got 17 pencils, 4 pens, 9 books. So the total number of gift she had received is 30. So making table makes it easy to understand the collection of data. Now let's see next one. Next day, in the class, Nandu started asking each boy and girl, "How do you come to school?" He took down their answers and he made a table. He made a list according students come by bus, students come by rickshaw, students who come walking, students come on a bicycle, and lastly, students come by car. And at last, he got a table. After seeing the table, we come to know that 10 students come by bus, 7 students come by rickshaw, 6 students come walking, 5 students come on a bicycle, and 2 students come by car. Now let's see next one. It was not required to wear the uniform on Thursday. Children had come to school wearing clothes of different colors. Alan made a table showing this. Salma suggested that instead of writing names, they could put one mark for each child. Now here you can see two tables. One table made by Alan and another table made by Salma. Now Alan has made the columns like color of clothes, She has mentioned name of children and lastly number of children. Salma has mentioned color of clothes, tally marks and number of children. Now let us see and compare the tables. Now Alan is showing four children wearing red color dress. Similarly, Salma. Two children wearing green dress. Salma also shows two children wearing green dress. Yellow 7. Even Salma is showing yellow 7. Blue 10. Here blue also 10. But instead of writing children name, Salma has used lines which is called tally marks. Now let us compare whether the tally marks and number of children are same. So red color we can see 4 lines which means 4. Green we can see 2 lines which means 2. Yellow we can see 7 lines that is 7. And blue we can see 10 lines that is 10. So the number of children wearing red is 4 and so is the number of marks. That's how and that's why they are called tally marks. Tally marks makes our work easier and faster.